everyone. To start with, allow me to thank Birzeit University that made us used to seeing it in the front line, and to thank those, the organizers of this activity, allowing me this opportunity to avail myself this opportunity to speak to you on the issue of unions. And I thank my friend Dr. Mudar Qassis, who has had an important role in organizing this activity. But the subject of my paper, The Decline in the Role of the Trade Unionism in Palestine, Causes and Prospects Within the Framework of the National Project Renewal, I'll start addressing those of age who witnessed the rise of unions, that is, in the stage before the establishment of the Palestinian National Authority. The unions were the leaders for the national activism, and their compound or their headquarters was the leadership, because unions is an organized large framework that can affect activity through activism and through its members. The engineers, the bar association, the doctors' union, the agricultural engineers, the veterinarians, the dentists, all of them were under the professional unions compound, and they had an important leading role in confronting with the Israeli occupation, as a result of which many of the professionals were arrested and many of them were under house arrest, such as engineer Ibrahim Daqaq and Jamil Nasser Othman and many other such leaders. Why this role was important, why it had an effect, because this was one of the tools for the Palestinian national struggle, one of the experiences, like the experience of the municipalities. When we had the municipal elections in the 70s, it was one of the tools for expressing the Palestinian national struggle, which produced a number of leaderships, including our dear friend who is sitting here, Mr. Abdel Jawad Saleh, then Karim Khalaf, and Bassam Shaka, God bless their souls. They had an experience. Now, why do we say there is a decline in the role of the trade unionism? First, let's see if there is a decline or not. I believe measuring a decline, if any, this should take into consideration the nature of the circumstances and the time. I believe there is a decline. There is a decline. There is a tangible decline. Why? Because usually unions, they have two roles. One that is of public, and the other one has to do with demands. The public one, before the Palestinian Authority, the unions had an important role. Currently, there is a decline on this role. Even on their unionist demands, there is a little bit decline on both sides, the public and the unionist one. Why? Why is that decline? Here, when we say unions, we speak in general. This includes all the unions, the popular unions as well. Yes, there is an issue that we keep repeating all the time, which is the nature of the Palestinian speciality in the Palestinian context. And I'm not using this as a pretext for our failure, if any, but I'm speaking about the speciality of the experience significance and the speciality of different nations. The construction struggle started after the liberation. That's why they used to say, you place the first stone on the footsteps after the last footstep of the last occupier. But here we are building before we finish the liberation, or maybe we have not liberated. Under the occupation and the battle of construction, there is a contradiction between occupation and construction. Every time you want to build, the occupation will demolish. Also the liberation and construction tools, they do not meet. The liberation is the militias, is the factions and demonstrations, whereas the building is the rule of law, judicial independence, public liberties. How can both of these meet if the factions are the main tool per se for liberation? Then they will have arms. So in the rule of law, you shouldn't have arms. So naturally, there will be a contradiction between the tools for liberation and for construction. So this speciality has reflected itself on all walks of life in the Palestinian life and all experiences, including that of the unions. Why? Because this experience that brought together the battle of liberation and construction has confused the unions. First, they knew what was their priority. It was facing the occupation in the public aspect, not on the demand or unionist one. On the demands or unionist one, it was more of a public one as well. That's why currently, after the battle was or included the construction or the building one, it couldn't, the unionism couldn't prioritize its actions. If they are working on their demands, who they will be facing? Will they be facing the private sector, as Mr. Mahmoud said, or the public sector represented by the Palestinian Authority? Now, where is the public side? So this issue has confused the has confused the unionism and led to the decline of its role. The second one, which is important, another factor for their decline, is the return of the Palestinian factions to the homeland. In the past, the unions were the forefront for political action because they had that form of public legitimacy, whereas the factions were prohibited. So all factions, such as the Democratic Front and others, they have the interest of being within the union so that they can confront the occupation, because they can then have any action on the ground, but rather underground or through the unionism. Otherwise, they'll be arrested or deported for a long period of time. So the return of factions to the homeland presented presence of the original instead of the proxy one through the union. The factions, they wanted now to take up their political role within the public and the masses. And so they didn't need that proxy or the unions, a matter that weakened the unions and made them retreat back to their demands or unionists and to the semi-public instead of the direct public one. This is one of the reasons. Another factor The third factor is the references. We have the Palestinian unions. They have different legal references. In the West Bank, their legal reference is the former Jordanian laws that were in place before 1967. And in Gaza, the Palestinian laws were the Egyptian laws that were there. Whereas the unions that were following the PLO were based on the references of the PLO. So we have a number of references. And these are, very old. Some of them are outdated. Some of the reference, legal references date back to the 30s. The penal code in Gaza is 74 of the year 1936. And here the penal code is from the 60s. Same thing, you're speaking about a law that is the revolutionary law of 1979. So you are speaking about the multiplicity of the legal framework. So every union has a different legal framework, and at the same time, all the legal laws, they cannot meet the requirements for modernization and to keep up with the current developments. Amata, that has led to the weakening of the unionism. Another reason for the decline is the Palestinization of the unions. Although in spite of around 25 years of the age of the Palestinian Authority, the Palestinian unions, especially the professional ones that have laws in Beit Hanina, their majority, they depend on Jordanian, not Palestinian laws. We hear about the dentists, engineers unions. Many of them are branches or offices for Jordanian unions, and they still apply the laws that are before, the laws that existed before 1967, because they cannot apply any amendments to these very laws in Jordan. So the only union is the Bar Association. Because from the start we went to the Palestinian Legislative Council and we created a Palestinian law. This issue has been discussed more than once, that it should be considered as a priority to nationalize these unions so that you can have legal frameworks can serve the needs of the Palestinian needs for the Palestinian context of these unions. Another reason, which is related to the return of the factions, the attempts of the political factions to enter the unions to, as an expression of presence. So they need to be in the union. This has damaged a lot. In the past, we had factional thought before the occupation. All the factions wanted to have some factional formation or presence or structure within the unions. When they returned, now they are more adamant or determined to show or for the visibility of these factions within the unions. So what to do in facing this situation? First of all, we need to go for the unification of unions. We cannot accept having different unions for one sector, saying this union is for Democratic Front and this one is for Fatah and this one is for Mr. X and that one for Mr. X. We need to have a legal framework for unifying these. Like for laborers, to have one union. For doctors, same thing. But this multiplicity and parallelism, it weakens the unionist action. Also, as we said in the past, to reactivate the issue of unions, that is to develop the front activism.
Unfortunately, now most of the factions are now working on without a collective vision. We don't see lists within union elections that have the idea of the collective, and if there are coalitions or alliances, there are only among two factions in the best case scenario. There was an idea to have lists within the union, like the idea of the general elections, meaning that all the factions know how much they will get as a list or as a faction with the represented within the union. This gives the possibility of making taking stock of all the experiences of the different factions.